I was born in 1917. My grandmother had 20 acres of land up there, all cleaned up. My grandfather and my grandmother, the house joined together, both got water out of the same spring. Said, I'm not using damn water. I was smarter than y'all. I caught my own water.
I came into Occoquan in 1938. And then they used to have the baptism down at the river. And they would walk from the church down there. And it seemed like to me the women or the girls, they would have on something white when they was baptized. The minister, he would be in the water, and they would lead them out to him. And then my wife's brother, he had his boat there that if it was too far, he'd row them out to the minister, then they'd baptize.
The Occoquan Watershed Monitoring Laboratory was the entity established by the Occoquan policy. We're actually part of the Civil and Environmental Engineering Department of the College of Engineering at Virginia Tech. Our laboratory has been here in Manassas since 1972 and has served to develop a long-term water quality record of of water quality in the reservoir and also of the performance of the Upper Occoquan Sewage Authority Water Reclamation Plant. Our studies have ranged from maintenance of a time series of water quality in the reservoir to testing the performance of various.
And I've lived for 78 years on Cedar Run, and I've spent about 50 of those years trying to protect it and the countryside that drains into it. I feel it's of tremendous importance for the people who live downstream and depend upon this water for their lives, really. The mountain that over here is Wildcat Mountain. Over here are the Watery Mountains. Here are the Pignut Mountains, and over behind me are the Bull Run Mountains.
The Outdoor Lab is a 210-acre facility in Broad Run, Virginia. Every year, 9,000 Arlington County Public School students come to the lab as part of their science curriculum. Here they study water temperature.
Some scientists test water quality by looking higher on the food chain. Stream-dwelling fish feed on insect larvae. Insects and fish die in unhealthy streams. The greater the number of species of fish, the healthier the stream water.
We started out and we were kind of surprised that there weren't a lot of fish. We weren't seeing a lot of fish. But the habitat is really shot right now. Once we did find some better habitat areas, we did find several species of fish. This guy right here is a cutlips minnow. It's one of our native fishes. Another fish that we found several of is this guy, the green sunfish. They're very pretty. They're probably one of the top level predators in this system. So we've got here two different species of sunfish. We've got a green sunfish and a redbreast sunfish. The other fish that we've seen that I know about are black-nosed dace. That's a very common fish. It's kind of probably one of the more abundant fish in the system. We also saw some white suckers. Creek chub sucker is another fish that I don't typically see in Fairfax County streams. Another fish we saw some darters. I believe everyone we've seen so far are tessellated darters. Additionally, some other forage species we saw, the spot-tail shiner and the crescent shiner. So that's just something that you typically see in a warm water stream in the Piedmonts.
I was born July the 23rd, 1919. I was born in this house. It was just a regular good-sized stream running, And then if it come a rain, a hard rain, well, it would get way up. But average times, you could walk right across. Well, after the dam was built, you couldn't walk across. You had to swim across or use a boat to get from one side to the other. Or that swinging bridge, if you want to use that.
Today, the lake is full, and the stream looks very different. We no longer have a waterfall on the rocks, but it's also changed the character of the stream in ways that you won't necessarily see right away. It's changed the wildlife, it's changed the fish in the stream. We used to have a variety of native fishes and game fishes. Now we have mostly carp coming up from the lake and keeping it muddy and preventing other fish from breeding in the stream.
Regulated water source into the reservoir is the discharge from the Upper Occoquan Sewage Authority. The treated water is the reservoir's cleanest and most reliable source. It may be the most analyzed water in the world. By the Sewage Authority, by the Fairfax County Water Authority, the Occoquan Water Monitoring Laboratory, state scientists, and by numerous universities performing independent research on this unique reservoir. The independent projects often provide insight far beyond regulatory tests required by the government.
All natural waters have bacteria in them. As a microbiologist, I would always contend that bacteria are the most important cleansers of natural waters. Bacteria are present in all natural waters, whether it's...
Fairfax County was the first Occoquan jurisdiction to take preventive land use and development planning action to reclaim the Occoquan's water quality.
I've been involved in preserving the Occoquan since my days 20 years ago on the Fairfax County Board of Supervisors, where we took 41,000 acres of land and downzoned it and were able to prove to the courts of Virginia that it protected the drinking water by holding down intense development. This is one of the smartest decisions I think this county has ever made. As a result of that, we have some of the cleanest water in the country for us to drink here in Prince William and Fairfax counties, and in addition to that, our water supply, our local supply, is plentiful at a time when many of the surrounding jurisdictions are suffering from drought and other water scarcities.
Enforcement of the Federal Clean Water Act may require implementation of low-impact design standards. The standards allow landowners to develop land at a profit, but they must maintain forested areas, reduce the amount of pavement and lawns, and use rainwater as a resource. The Northern Virginia Regional Commission coordinates regular meetings with all jurisdictions and stakeholders to find ways to meet these standards and improve Occoquan water quality. They navigate the complex technical and political challenges to maintain clean water in a rapidly urbanizing watershed through the Occoquan Technical Advisory Committee. By fostering cooperation among watershed jurisdictions, the commission becomes a key player for improving the Occoquan Reservoir. The final job of reclaiming water for drinking rests with the Fairfax County Water Authority. Local jurisdictions use different processes to protect land adjacent to the reservoir. Fairfax County governs the northern border of the reservoir. The county assisted the Northern Virginia Regional Park Authority to purchase and manage the northern shore. The result is a successfully maintained forested buffer, interrupted only by the development of recreational centers. The buffers protect the reservoir from polluted stormwater and groundwater drainage. The center provides an opportunity for the public to experience an environment that would have been lost if the land were privately developed. Fishing is a popular activity at Fountainhead Regional Park. People come from all over to fish one of the area's best lakes for largemouth bass and crappie. And competitive rowing is taken to a higher level at the Sandy Run Regional Park. From here, both beginners and Olympic athletes practice and compete in some of the nation's top races. Universities from as far away as New England come to the Occoquan to practice on one of the finest stretches of water in the East Coast. To reclaim natural, clean sources of water once abundant in the watershed is not just a technological challenge. It will require a change in our understanding and commitment. to reclaim the childhood adventures of mullet holes that created bold, adventurous adults will take a change in our collective vision. And to reclaim a deeper connection to these waters will take a change of heart.